Let's stick with Europe for now, where we have seen mixed asset funds dominating inflows in the last few months. According to Lipper data, these funds saw inflows of 5 billion euros in April.
In fact, what we saw is that on the back of market volatility, equity and bond sales fell while multi-asset picked up.
In the US, what we saw was the deployment of more active ETF strategies. While smart beta products remain the priority, we have seen Vanguard and iShares hedge their bets with quant active equity ETFs, and JP Morgan Asset Management launching an active long short product.
Well, Dariush, according to data, active ETFs saw net inflows of $8.6 billion in the first 4 months of the year, with active fixed income ETFs taking the lion's share in April. We're joined now by John Siciliano to discuss some of these matters. John, thanks for taking the time to be here with us. With Vanguard and BlackRock, among others, becoming more active in this space, do you believe that these products are going to become more popular in the coming year?
It's fascinating to see how rapidly smart beta has grown. The approximate market size of smart beta today is around $500 billion. When you think that after the great financial crisis, there was a reluctance to be active in quantitative investing, clearly that is a sentiment that has changed. As a result, I would argue that over the intermediate to long term, you're going to continue to see a tremendous amount of interest in smart beta as people try to find the opportunity to be both active and passive simultaneously.
And do you think this signals a natural progression for active asset management, especially seeing the popularity of passives over the last few years?
I think it's a way for people to participate in what I would almost call semi-active management. It gives you the opportunity to achieve certain exposures in a predetermined or predefined fashion, which gives you some greater opportunities in certain investors' minds than they find in traditional passive.
Thanks, John. Let's have a look at what's been making headlines in the world of passives.